So today we will see the philosophy of Jainism. What is the Jainism? How it emerged, and what is the basic fundamental philosophical principle of Jainism? And then in the next class we will see the educational philosophy of Jainism. What are the educational implications of Jainism philosophy? That we will see in the next class. So when we see the Jainism, actually when we you will see the origin of Jainism, you will find that the word Jain, actually Jain is the philosophy, and when it comes into the transaction, then we tell it as Jainism, ism we used to add. So when we see the Jain, actually Jain word is derived from the word gene, J-I-N, gene. This is the word from which the Jain is derived. And the literary meaning of gene is a person who have controlled their life, who have controlled themselves, who have conquered themselves. So controlling from what? The controlling from the jealousy, enmity, or the physical desire, leisure. So those who have controlled, those who are beyond that, they are called a Jain. And the philosophy of Jain is known as the Jainism. So Jainism is literally meant by the person, those who have controlled their enmity, jealousy. And how it can be controlled? By the means of education. So this is the fundamental meaning of Jain. And the Jainism, which is in the present shape, is actually the effort of their proponents, their you can say that the Tirthankar, they used the word as a Tirthankar. And in the Jainism, there are total 24 Tirthankars. Okay, there are total 24 Tirthankars are there. And the Jainism, which is in the present shape, is actually a contribution of those 24 Tirthankars. They have contributed, they have thought that what should be the education, what should be the way of life. We will see the different aspect in the very detail we cannot see, but very in the brief manner we will see. So actually the present shape of Jainism is the contribution of those 24 Tirthankars. Out of those 24 Tirthankar, if you want to know the name, I can. Those 24 Tirthankars were Adinath, who is also known as Rishabhdev, then the Ajitnath, Shambhavanath, Abhinandannath, Sumatinath, Padma Prabhu, Suprabhanath, Chandra Prabhu, Suvidhinath, Sitalanath, then Shreyansnath, Vishu Pujya, Vimalanath, then Anantanath, Dharmanath, Santinath, Kuntunath, Aranath, Mallinath, Munishu Vrita, then Naminath, Neminath, Parshvanath, and Mahavira, who is also known as the Vardhaman. And so in this 24, we see that the Adinath or Rishabhnath, He was the first Tirthankar of the Jain, and the last Tirthankar was the Lord Mahavira, who is also known as the Vardhaman. Okay, so they were the Tirthankars of Jainism. And when we see the Jainism, you will find that Jainism is not a theist philosophy, means the philosophy which believes in the existence of God, who accepts and acts as per the learning of Vedas, doctrines, religious doctrine. They are not theist philosophers. They are atheist, means who don't believe in the existence of God. They don't believe in the existence of God. And but very surprisingly, they believe in the existence of soul. Soul is not the literary meaning of a soul that we see in the religious literature. Soul here is meant by the jeev. Jeev and ajeev. These are the two terms they used to have in the Jainism. Ajeev, which does not have a life, and a jeev, which have a life. And the jeev here is termed as the soul. So they accept the existence of a soul. Means there is a something in the jeev, means which can live. And that's why they are known as Atmavadi Darshan. Darshan is a philosophy. So that's why they are Atmavadi Darshan, because they believe in the living creatures. And as for the Jainism, they say that every soul, every jeev have an inherent capacity of knowing everything. Means if there is a jeev, if there is a soul, then it have a capacity of knowing, and it can know everything. That is the basic characteristics of a soul as per the Jain philosophy. They can know everything. They have a capacity. And if the soul is in the perfect position, means if it is a perfection, then it can know anything. And if it is not in the perfect position, if it is not in the perfection, then it can not know. So the ability of knowing of by the soul, by the living things, ability of knowing means ability of learning. It depends upon the perfection of a soul. If the soul is a perfect, then it can know anything. It have a power, capacity of knowing unlimited things. That is the characteristics feature of a soul as per the Jain philosophy. And they also says that what causes imperfection of a soul? What is the cause? Because if I am saying that a soul can know anything, but the ability of a knowing will depend on the degree of perfection. So there must be something which is causing the imperfection of a soul. And then they define the influence of a body and mind, which cause the karma. Because a karma is activity. Karma is an activity. So activity causes the imperfection of the soul. Means what kind of activity you are performing, that will cause a imperfection in the shoe, and that imperfection causes the inability in the learning. And the karma is influenced by body and mind. So if your soul is a perfect, you can know unlimited things, unlimited. And even they also characterize the soul. What is the soul? They define soul are characterized by the intelligence, and their differences are due to their connection with a matter. Soul are the substance which is characterized by the intelligence. Intelligence means has an ability to know. That's why the soul will be characterized by the intelligence, and the soul will have an ability to know. That is the basic characteristics principle of soul as per the Jain philosophy. Then that we have seen that how the Jain is immersed, what is the literary meaning, who are the Tirthankars, then what is the basic conception about the soul as per the Jainism. Then the next comes the principle of Jainism. What are the main principle of Jainism? Basic principle. The first principle of Jainism is Satya Syadvad. The first principle is Syadvad. And this Syadvad principle, according to Jainism, says that, just wait 1 minute. The Syadvad principle of the first principle of Jainism says that every person is an incomplete, and it is the knowledge which makes the person complete. Every person is an incomplete, and it is the knowledge which makes the person complete. And the knowledge of a common man is a partial and incomplete. Common man have a partial knowledge, and that's why they are incomplete. And since they are incomplete, since they have a partial knowledge, and that's why they don't have a perfect decision. That's why they have a imperfect decision, because their knowledge and their understanding is not perfect. So the kind of decision that they will be taking, that will be also imperfect. And the decision taken by the person depend upon the degree of knowledge that they have. Okay, so according to the Jainism, a decision can be true from a specific point of view, because it's not a perfect. So it will be true at a specific point of view, not always. Like that in the modern science also, we used to say that the truth that we used to say, it is with reference to something. It is with reference to something. It is not always true. Suppose that we say that the classroom that in which I am sitting, it is the stationary. Yes, it is a stationary from the point of a reference of earth surface. But from the all part of a universe, it will not be a stationary one. It will be moving. And the path of movement will also be different from a different point of a reference. So it will not be perfect, and that's why they used to prefix the word syat, and from there the syatvad word comes. Syat is meant by the probability, hana. So they used to prefix the word probability. They don't confirm it that it is the as a universal truth. Okay, so that is the one of the syatvad. Then the next one is the principle of knowledge. The next one is the principle of knowledge. The next principle of Jainism, and as per the Jainism, the knowledge which is in the Jain philosophy known as the Janana. Janana is a Hindi word for knowing. Okay, so as per the Jain philosophy, Janana is the soul's intrinsic and inherent inseparable attribute, as earlier I was also saying, that the knowing is the soul's intrinsic and inherent inseparable attribute, without which no soul can exist. So if the soul is existing, you can say that there will be the existence of a knowledge, means it have ability to know. And if there is a knowledge, then there is a existence of a soul, because they are inseparable. They cannot be separated. They are inseparable. So this is the thing. Then knowledge plays an important part in the conception of a soul and its emancipation. Because the knowledge, because the soul have an intrinsic inherent attribute of knowing everything, and it can know unlimited thing. So the knowledge plays an important part in the conception of a soul and its emancipation, means the liberation, that getting the moksha. If a soul will be satisfied with a knowledge, then only it can get a moksha. Otherwise, it cannot get a moksha. And when we talk about the knowledge, as per the Jain philosophy, there are two types of a knowledge. One is the cognition, which is known as the, are you getting me? Hello.
Yes sir. Voice break ho raha hai.
Voice break ho raha hai.
Yes sir.
Anyway, because there is an internet connectivity in the department, so where you will not be able to listen, you can directly tell me. Otherwise, it will be available on the YouTube also. You can tell me also that I am not getting the voice in between. If there is a problem exists, you can say. So when we see about the knowledge, as per the Jain philosophy, there are two types of a knowledge. One type is a cognition, which is Janana, and the another type of a knowledge is the sensation, that is the darshan. There are two type of a knowledge in the Jain philosophy. Okay, so there are two type of a knowledge. The first type of a knowledge, which is the cognition or the Janana, it is further divided into the two, again the two types. The first one is the valid knowledge, and the second one is the fallacious knowledge. Valid knowledge, which is the true, which is the truth. and which is the fruitful, which is the good knowledge, which is for the betterment of a society, betterment of the mankind, betterment of the nature, that are known as the valid knowledge. And which is not good, that knowledge is known as the falsious knowledge. The true knowledge can come from the sensuous mati, that I will explain later on also, mati, then the sruta, then the abadhi, and mana, pragya, and kevals. These are the five types of valid knowledge, and there are three types of falsious knowledge also, like a kumati, kusruta, and vibhang. These are the total eight type of cognitive knowledge, and there are four type of sensation or darshan. These are the visual, which is the chakshu, non-visual, which is the achakshu, and this is the avadhi darshan and pure or kevala darshan. So when we, so one by one we will see what are these type of knowledge. The first which I was saying here, that is the visual or the chakshu. Visual knowledge are those type of knowledge which can be senses, because this visual, non-visual comes under the sensation. Sensation means a darshan, means which knowledge which can be gathered through the sensory organs. So one is the visual, that is the chakshu, which we can know by use of the visual organs. Okay. Here the visual organ is not only limited to the eye. Visual organ is the all organ which have a sensory capability, like this skin, like the nose, all are the sensory organ which comes under the visual chakshu. Non-chakshu, which is non-visual, which the type of a knowledge which can be gathered through a non-sensory part of the body. Okay, then the abadhi darshan and the pure darshan, pure sensation, that is the kevala. When we talk about the pure or kevala darshan, it is a sensing all things of the universe. That is the all type of a knowledge, whether it is a sensory, whether it is a non-sensory, whether we are getting through any mode of acquiring knowledge, that will be a pure or a kevala darshan, sensation. And the avadhi darshan is a sensation of the mysterious part or aspect of a material thing. The point of saying is that when we talk about the visual and a non-visual, it is a general or normal type of a knowledge which can be gathered. Whereas the avadhi and kevala knowledge, it is a some type of extra sensory. You can understand like that by intuition, and like that I was explaining about the pure or a kevala knowledge, means all type of a knowledge in the universe. Like sometimes we know about from the intuition, sometimes we know about the guessing. And these type of knowledge will be covered under the pure and the Avadhi Darshan. Then now come to the type of a knowledge. The first type is the mati. Under that I was saying cognition knowledge. That the type of a knowledge I was explaining under the darshan or sensation. Now type of a knowledge under the cognition. The first type is the mati. Mati, or it is also known as the sensuous knowledge. Mati or a sensuous knowledge is the ordinary cognition attained by normal functioning of a sense perception. By sensing, by perceiving, the kind of a knowledge that we get is the mati. The next one is the Shruta, or it is also known as the authoritative knowledge. Shruta or authoritative knowledge is the knowledge derived through the symbols, sign or a word. That all type of a verbal knowledge is a Shruta knowledge. All type like that I am telling you. So the signs and the symbols I am saying, as I was explaining in the models of communication. So this type of a knowledge that you will be getting, it will be Shruta knowledge, authoritative knowledge. And when you will learn by using your sensory organ, that will be Mati. Then the next one is that next one is the Avadhi Janana, that is the periodic knowledge. This type of a knowledge we get due to the cooperation of a place and time, and like that in physics we used to study the time space relationship. Because all the things in the higher physics, in order to understand, we have to understand about the time and space relationship. So simply you can understand that the spatial kind of a knowledge, and spatial knowledge where it is required to understand the depthness of the objects in the universe, the position of an object in the universe, that type of a knowledge is known as the Avadhi knowledge or the periodic knowledge. There are some knowledge which we get through the inner emotion. By the emotional burst, we used to know something. Those are known as the inner knowledge. And if we are getting some knowledge through the self-realization, self-thinking, realization, mediation, those are known as the self-realization or the Kaivalya Janana. So these are the types of knowledge in the principle of knowledge. There are a lot, something I have to.
Valid knowledge.
1 minute. हाँ दुर्गा, एक मिनट रुक जाइए, मैं फिर और बात करता हूँ. बहुत सारा बताना है इसमें. अच्छा एक चीज है, मैं उसको बता करके क्वेश्चन आंसर करता हूँ. बहुत सारा चीज है इसमें. एक इसमें जब हम प्रिंसिपल ऑफ, व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ जैनिज्म, देयर इज अ प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इमांसिपेशन. how we can get a moksha as per the Jain philosophy. So there are total three principle of emancipation. The first one is the samyak drishti, which is the perfect vision. So through the perfect vision you can get a emancipation. Perfect vision means you must accept all the element like a jeev, ajeev, bandhan and all those things. If you are accepting, then you have a perfect vision, and by having a perfect vision you can get a emancipation as per the Jainism. Then the next one is, the second one is the perfect janana, means perfect knowledge. If you have a enthusiasm of learning, motivation of knowing the things, then you have a perfect knowledge, and through which you can also get a moksha. And the last one is the samyak charitra. Samyak charitra means if you are following a non-violence, if you are speaking truth, if you don't have a habit of stealing anything, okay, if you don't have a feeling of a jealousy, enmity from anyone, then you can also get a moksha. So these are the three principle of emancipation as per the Jainism. Jain, they also believe about the bandha tattva. Bandha tattva is known as the element of a rebirth. The Jainis, they believe in the rebirth, and they say that a soul can get a rebirth after its one life is over. This is the bandha tattva. There is a principle of karma also. So that is not very much important from the education point of view. So there are lot when we talk about the Jainism philosophy, but these are the basic principle of Jain philosophy. Okay, and the rest, its educational implication, we will see in the next class. But we have now a time for question answer session. So if anybody have a doubt or you want to ask something more, you can ask now. I know that the discussion was not very elaborate. Actually, it should take two class, but I hope that it will must have given you some understanding about the Jainism. Okay, so Durga, what you are saying, can you repeat your question?
Sir, jo amro jo cognition jo janan achi sethare ti prakar knowledge achi, valid knowledge gota rahila, falsious knowledge rahila. Valid knowledge sir kete prakar sir valid knowledge te kete prakar koile apan seta jodi jani paile suni paile sethare valid knowledge te kete prakar ho, how many types valid knowledge,
how many types are in the valid knowledge and how many types in the falsious knowledge.
फलसीस में सर कुमति कुश्रुत आउ देन फलसीस लास्ट सर कोन मु सुनी पाइलिन से टाइम.
ओके 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 द टोटल वैलिड नॉलेज आर ऑफ फाइव टाइप्स. देयर आर फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ अ वैलिड नॉलेज, दैट इज द सेंसियस व्हिच इज द मति एंड द ऑथोरिटेटिव व्हिच इज द श्रुता. देन द नेक्स्ट वन इज द क्लैरियवंत क्लैरियंत. I will write the spelling. I think that will it will make it clear. Clairvoyant, and which is known as the avadhi. Then the next one is the telepathy, which is known as the manah pragna. And then the last one is the pure kevalas. These are the five type of a valid knowledge. Then the three type of a falsious knowledge, like a kumati, कुश्रुता और विभंग. विभंग आई विल टाइप इन द चैट बॉक्स. दिस इज द विभंग and this is the CLA. Okay, these are the total, in total 8 type of knowledge are there. Okay, so next question.
Sir. Hello.
हाँ हाँ बोलिए.
सर जो अवधि नॉलेज जो सर आपन कहले जो सेंसेस जो सेंसेशन ऑफ मिस्टीरियस थिंग्स इन द यूनिवर्स सर आपको टिके जस्ट एक्सप्लेन कर परिबे कि
अच्छा अच्छा Avadhi knowledge, when we talk, na, it is a type of knowledge that we get with the space relationship. Hai na? Time of a space, time and space relationship. The knowledge which we get from the time and space relationship. Like that, when we talk about the first two type of knowledge, which is Shruta and Mati. For that, we have to come into the contact with the object in order to know that. But there are some knowledge like that we know about the sun, we know about the moon, without coming into the contact with the object. Isn't it? So that type of a knowledge is known as the avadhi janana. Means you can know about the object even you are very far distance from the object. These are the avadhi jana.
Sir, आप बोले कि सर ये जो about Jainism जो मतलब Jainism philosophy that is all about आत्मवाद दर्शन and sir आप बोले कि जो है दो टाइप का होता है कुछ ऐसा जीवो अजीवो जैसे हमारा बेसिकली जैसे हमें से नॉर्मली पता है कि जीवो में हमारा जो सोल होता है आत्मा होता है बट अजीवो में तो नहीं पता तो ये कैसे हुआ कि जीवो अजीवो सर ये थोड़ा सा अजीवो में कैसे मतलब ये जो हमारा आत्मवाद जो दर्शन है ये कैसे जस्टिफाई कर रहा है थोड़ा सा
ओके ओके सी Pallavi, first thing in the very beginning of the discussion I told that the literary meaning of a soul that we know from the religious doctrine is that have a different meaning. Here the meaning of a soul is the jeev, is the living organism.
Yes, sir.
The literary meaning of a soul is a different in the religious literature. Right? So that is a different one. Here the soul is meant by the living organism which have a life. And this Jain philosophy says that the thing which have a life, it has the ability to know everything. So knowing is the inseparable attribute of the soul. So if there is soul, then it will know. Okay, that is the thing. So the literary meaning is not like that which you are perceiving from the other literature. And now come to the ajeev. So when you will see the Jain philosophy, they have a concept of a matter. Na? They have a concept of a matter, and according to the Jainism, matter is what which can possess the quality or attribute. That is the matter, and within the matter, two types of a matters are there. One is the astikaya, that is the bodied, and one is the anastikaya, which is the unbodied.
Yes, sir.
When you will see the religious literature, other religious literature, the soul that we perceive is the unbodied, which doesn't have a body. What is the secondary thing for the sutta as per the religious literature? But here, the soul is the body. Soul have a body. Hai na? Matter is of two type. One is the astikaya, which have a body. Another one is the anastikaya, which don't have a body. ठीक है, ये वाला मैंने नहीं एक्सप्लेन किया था. इट ऑल्सो कम अंडर द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ जैनिज्म आई थॉट, बट इफ यू आस्क आई हैव बीन एक्सप्लेन. है ना, दिस इज द एक्चुअली द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ जैनिज्म एंड इट इज द फॉर्म ऑफ जीव. व्हाट आर द फॉर्म्स ऑफ जीव? सो सॉरी, नॉट अ फॉर्म ऑफ जीव, प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैटर, अंडर द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैटर. So, as per the Jainism, there are two type of matter. One is the bodied, another one is the unbodied. Unbodied means which does not have a body. And the bodied means which have a body. Then, which have a body, there is a two types again. One is the soul, which is the jiv. Another one is the matter, which is the ajiv. Like that, the stones. है ना, लाइक दैट दिस एनी अदर थिंग्स विच डज नॉट हैव अ जीव. एंड देन द जीव विच इज द सोल. सोल इज द बॉडी. सो हियर द कॉन्सेप्शन ऑफ अ सोल इज अ डिफरेंट. ओके, एंड देर इज अ अजीव. एंड ऑन द अदर साइड व्हेन यू विल सी द अनबॉडीड, देर इज अ डिफरेंट टाइप्स, लाइक अ काल विच इज अ टाइम. टाइम and time is also of a two types, so it will go in depth, so let it be. So here the jeev and a jeev and a soul have a different conception. So all the living organism is the jeev, is the soul as the Jain philosophy. Okay, and that's why the matter of rebirth come, and that's why the matter of knowledge comes, because it accepts the all ajeev have a ability to learn, ability to know. However, the degree of knowledge, degree of knowing will depend upon the perfection of a soul. How much you are perfect. If you are very much perfect, then you have unlimited capacity of knowing. If you have some imperfection, and imperfection from where it comes? It comes from the karma. And karma, how the karma influence? The karma is influenced by the body and the mind. Hai na? Because the body does something wrong. It is our mind which have a feeling of a jealousy. So if you have a feeling of a jealousy, if you are involved in a wrong thing, then you will become an imperfect. And if as soon as you will start becoming imperfect, then your ability of knowing will decrease. So in order to know more and more and learn more and more, you have to keep your mind and body perfect. That is a perfect soul. Is it clear to you, Pallavi?
थोड़ा थोड़ा हुआ है, बाकी सर पढ़ने से और थोड़ा क्लियर.
हाँ, पढ़ने से हो जाएगा. इसमें आप इतना याद रखिए कि द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ अ सोल इज नॉट द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ अ सोल व्हिच वी सी इन द रिलीजियस लिटरेचर. बिकॉज द रिलीजियस लिटरेचर दैट यू सी, इट इज द ऑर्थोडॉक्स व्हिच बिलीव इन द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ अ गॉड. The Jainism philosophy does not believe in the existence of a God. They don't believe that God exists. There is a God. So that's why inka pura jo base of thinking is a different. So other thing also become different from what is there in the orthodox philosophy.